Hi guys and welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how I made this drilling platform over there that you may have seen in the Red Power computer tutorial. So let's get started. First off, I'm doing this in creative mode, but of course you can do it in survival as well. But it would take me a lot longer, so I'm using creative here. So first I am starting with the base, which is this frame, the bottom one. It has a center and then it goes four into every direction. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And then we just fill it in. Okay. Then we find the center, which is, I think, this block. Yes, exactly. And we carve the center out because that's where our pusher or our arm will be. Then we need to do a cross in the middle, just like that. That's because we don't want the middle to push the whole platform down, and because if I would have a frame there and the frame here, this would be connected and I don't want that, so I'm just doing a cross free space in the middle, or a plus sign, whatever you like. Then I'm adding the second layer, which is basically the same as the first one. I'm just using the corners here to connect this, just because I think it looks cool. Okay. That's just fine. Now we can remove this. It was just temporary. And this is step one already done. This is the base layer of our drilling machine. The next thing we may want to do is adding the motors. And we can do this. Let me just grab one. Where are they? Frame motors. Ooh. There's the frame and there's the motor. Alright. Okay. Maybe an screwdriver as well. Okay. And then we add one here. One here. One here. One here, one here, one here, one here, and one here. Oops, no, not there, here. And then we need to turn them in the correct directions. Come on. Well, I think the turning has a little bit of problems with the smart moving mod. Yes, it seems like it. Yes, that's correct. And yes. Alright. Yes. Okay. Well. What was it? F9 to disable? Yes. Okay. Let's try this again. Oh well, it doesn't want to. Okay. Yes, that's the correct direction, and this is also correct. So you want the first one to face that direction, and every one of those motors that is inside, so this one, this one, and this one, you want to face them outside. Yes, I think that should be it. Yes. Yes. Okay. Whoops, no, that's not what I wanted. Okay. So this is facing outward. Let's just turn them. And you want them, the arrow, you want to face this direction to the other frame. Yep. Correct. That is correct. And that is now correct. Because what happens is this frame motor will be turned to the top and this frame motor will move the complete frame in the direction, and this frame motor will then move this motor back to the default position. And you will see what I mean later. So this one needs to be turned up, just like that. And as well. And this one, and this one. So now those are turned upwards, and now we need to specify the direction we want them to go in. And if this one is facing this direction, this means the frame should move this direction for this motor to move this in this direction. So what we want is turn them right, right. This one's facing right, and this one's facing right. Now that's done, and it's getting dark. Just a second. Okay. Now the basic motor settings are now done. Now, of course, we need to supply them with energy. And to do that, first one, we need to clear out this one. And this one, and this one, and this one. And we just grab ourselves some batteries here. Batteries, there they are. By the way, if you right click, you get this menu, but if you shift right click, you can place a battery block on another battery, if you didn't know that. It's quite handy. So now we have supplied this motor with energy. And of course, if you are not familiar with how the frames work, the frames connect to each other and one block that is not a frame. So basically, this battery box right here wouldn't be connected because on top of it is another battery, and although the battery on top would be moved because it is directly connected to a frame, this one here is not. And to fix that, we need to place another frame here, so this battery is also connected to the whole frame. And if you screw up anywhere, if some part is not connected to the frame, it might be that the construction is blocked, and if you try to move the frame motor, nothing happens. And then you need to check your construction. It is basically something is blocking your frame construction that it can't move. So you forgot to place a frame anywhere. So now that this is done, we need to supply the other motor with energy, and we can do that from the top, just like that. And we can't do this here because this one is moving the frame, so we can't just put a battery on top there. Put one here, and put one here. And of course, this battery is now connected, but this frame again isn't. This frame motor right here isn't connected to the frame. And now we can connect this one by adding another frame here. Now this one is connected, but this one would also be connected, so it would block itself. So what we need to do there is we need to use a panel on this. And the thing is, the if you use a panel, you can use this these panels, which you can saw down from any block in the game, basically. It's a red power feature as well. And the panels are the smallest thing you can saw. And if you use those, and I'm just taking red here because it's easier to see what's happening or what I'm doing. And now these blocks here wouldn't connect. So basically, if I would do cobblestone here, this frame could be moved without moving the cobblestone until the cobblestone hits another uncovered frame. What you can also do is use a 2-wide, which is, I think, what is it called? A panel, and the other one is cover. I'm sorry, the covers are for the blocking. So everything you cover with a cover is blocked and will not move anything. And panels, just like this wooden one, you can put cables on. And you can see it also on the texture work. Everything that has panels has those edges of the frame. And if you just use a cover, it has no edges, it has just a corner of the frame. So it's hard to see, but you can make it out if you know what to look for. So what I need to do now is, I'm just clearing this once more, put one here, redo this, and do this and this. So the frame motor can move the frame, but the frame will not move the motor because we don't want that. Now place the thing again. Oh well. Kinda tricky. Cast off the bug. Turn it upside down. Now that's correct. And now it's also the correct direction. So now you can see it, but the arrow is on top and facing this direction, just as the other ones. And I'll probably cut two when it's done. Okay, now that's done. On every side, the top panels above the two motors, above this place and above this motor, are covered with the red covers. Here, 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 and here as well. And as you can see now, this motor is connected, this motor is connected, and also this battery is connected. So this construction would be able to be moved by the frame, and I have also powered it, so we can just test it out. Put a lever there, and as you see, construction moved. So nice. As well, I need to replant the motor again. Not a problem. Okay, that's done. So you have seen this one works. And you should frequently test out if your construction is working, because you might run into problems where you forgot to put a construction there, put a frame there, and the whole thing won't work. And let's say you have completed the whole construction there and it's not working, and you have basically no idea where the problem lies. So you should frequently test it out to see if there are any problems. So what we need to do now is we need to add, of course, the power to the motors. We have the batteries, but the batteries need power. So we grab ourselves some solar panels. And you can place the solar panel on this bare frame. So what we do is we use the panel. Yes, the panel, not the cover, the panel. And basically we can turn the complete upside of this into panels. Let's just do this. Okay, this is done. Now it looks much better as well. So what we can do now is, again, shift click. Not so the GUI doesn't open up. Shift click. And now we have a little problem, as you can maybe tell, because this solar panel is now not connected to any frame, as I just told you. So what we need is another frame there to connect those to the rest. So what I do here is we add a little support there and do this on every side. And I don't think you would need to clear this panel, but I do it just for safety. Then another one here, because we need to secure this as well. Then another one here, so this is secured as well. Another one here, and another one here. And now we could basically start putting down the panels, the solar panels. Let's just do this. And it's getting dark again. Okay. And now we have successfully supplied all the battery boxes with power. And you can see they are now filling up. Okay. And the frame should still be able to be moved. And we can just test it out in a second. If the batteries are filled up, let's just wait until that happens. Okay, now you see the motor is all lit up, and we can now use a lever to set them into motion. And again, the frame is moving, and now here to reset the motor. And that's basically it. And we have just moved the construction in this direction. To reverse it, we use this one and move it in the other direction. Okay. That one was easy. Now, you may notice that we need another motor or another two motors, because we need to move the arm up and down or the axis. So we would need a motor somewhere about here. So let's just add one there. And maybe here. And of course here would be the arm. But we're not going to add this in right now. So this one is pointing down, so this one needs to be pointing up. So we can go both directions. Wow. Nope. Wow. Don't do this to me. And of course these two motors need to be supplied with energy as well. So what I'm just doing now is I am adding some more batteries. Where are my batteries? There they are. Okay, now put a battery here and put a battery here. And of course those batteries are held by the frame here. And then we put another battery. No, not there. There. And you may notice this battery is just free floating, is not connected to any frame, as well as this. So what we do is we add a frame here and add a frame here, and then the problem is gone. Same on the other side. One, two, add a frame here and there. And now we have those motors supplied with energy as well. And now this was only to... Okay. Nice. This was only temporary. Of course, we need one here. And we need one here as well, of course. And one here. And now we could basically fill this up. But I'm going to show you what I did just now. So this one is there and we can't remove it because it is holding this little solar panel right there, because it is on top of this battery. And So this is the only frame that this is connected to. So this one holds this solar panel, so we can't remove this one. Now this one is for holding this battery, and this one is for holding this battery. And this little arm is connected on the main frame on this side. And this little step here is connected to the whole thing on this little arm. And I'm just doing this to cable the... Wow, it's getting dark again. Wow, that goes really fast. I'm using this to connect the motor to the cable afterwards. And you see how I do it in a second. So now that's basically done, and I can fill this top layer up as well. Okay. Okay. And now you see we have a little stair here, so we can put a cable down from this motor and from this motor as well. So these motors are connected to this frame and this frame. The battery boxes are connected here and here. The bottom battery box is connected by the small arm I just put there. Let's just watch this again from below. Okay. Now this is connected to the bottom. This connected to the bottom, and this here is connected to the top. So this would still work, and let's just test it out. So I'm not talking. Yes, it does indeed still work. That's great. No. Minecraft seriously needs a reset button. Yes, that was. That is correct. Okay, what we can do now is fill the rest in with those solar panels to produce a little more energy. That's just fine. Okay, and we need to leave a one wide space to put a cable there. And I'm going to do this in a second. So now, this one still works. This one is able to move. And now we're going to cable this up. But first, let me purify it a little bit. Let's go down back here. And we need panels on those anyway, because we want to put cable on there later on. So let's just do that. And the top layer, we can of course fill this in as well. Now I've filled in the top layer of the construction. Alright, and now I think we can start to put some cables on this thing. Let's just test out again if it's still working. It is. Great. And now you may think, how are we going to do this? Cables. Well, first on, let me grab a bundled cable, because we are going to need it. Bundled cable. Nice. And we are going to put it around this ring here. And that's why we have left the gap there. Okay, we wouldn't need to close it up, but, well, to keep it symmetrical. Let's put one there, and then we can start to cable this. And I'm just going to take black and red, I think. Black and red. Okay. So the black cable is for down, and the red cable is for up. Okay, done that there, and another pen. No, not this one. This one. And I've thrown out the bundled cable, haven't I? Yes, I have. Okay. So now these two motors are connected and I could now fire them up by using the black and the red cable on the bundled cable. And the station should still be moving, and let's just recheck. As I said, you can't check it often enough. Yes, it does still move. Great, great news. And now we want to connect all the motors. And the first one is pretty easy. We just do it that way. We bring the bundled cable down there. And then just put whatever color we like there. And I'm going to do this on every side. Here and here, bundled cable. Here and here, and the bundled cable. And here as well. And the bundled cable. And the other motor we connect on this side, because we can't connect it here because the motor is moving there. So this ain't working. So what I'm doing is I'm putting this cable, no, not this way. I'm putting this cable here. So bundled cable from there, and then just put a colored cable there. And I'm also going to do this on every side. Here, here, and there. And some bundled cable. And here as well. And here as well. Now we need some colored cable. So we throw out all the thing we have here. So we have a little bit of clear inventory. Okay, now we have some colors to our disposal. Sorry, I had to take a little break there. So where was I? Why is the bundled cable missing? I think I just tested something before I went. Okay, this was like that. Yes. Okay. Now we connect that. And connect this one, and connect this one, connect this one, and this one, and this one, and this one. Whoa, lag. Whoa. Okay, I did not know that you could put cable on there, but okay, that's fine. And now this one is basically done. So we have connected all those motors to the bundled cable. And we can use the bundled cable to fire up the machine. So now let's just do a little bit. No, not a glass pane. No mushrooms. No, thank you. Okay, now we can hide this cable by doing this. And of course, this still works because this panel is also connected to this frame and this frame. So there's no problem there. Now this is done, and it should still work. And let me just test it out later, because I don't want to remove all the cables just now. Okay, that is step two done. The complete frame is basically done now, and it is able to move in every direction. And if you just wanted to have a moving platform, you would basically be ready now. You could hook up this bundled cable to a Red Power computer and program it to move in any direction you want. But we are going to make a digging machine, just as I told you. And a digging machine, of course, needs an arm to dig something. And we are going to do this one next. Of course, we need a little more frames. Where are the frames? There are the frames. And of course, you see the problem. This one here would connect to this frame. And we don't want that, because we don't want to move the complete platform down. So what we do is we use the cover there. And again, I'm using red to clearly distinguish what areas are blocked off. And now you can put this up as high as you like. And as you see, this frame is not connected anywhere because we have dug out the plus sign in the beginning, and that's why we have clear areas everywhere where it could connect. So the only connection is up here, and we have blocked that by using the cover. So I have left this one free, and there is a reason for it. Because if you look here, of course, you don't want to waste the items, you want to grab the items and bring the items up, and that's why I have this tube. And this tube can be used to transport the items up into some chests. And you may notice a little problem, and I'm just going to show it. If you use a pneumatic tube, well, we need the redstone one. We can also use this. If I find it, redstone tube, yes. And now you see the problem. It connects to the batteries, which basically normally it shouldn't really matter, but to be safe, I am using panels on the left and on the right, so they won't connect. Oh, I see. Wrong direction. Okay. Little thing I did wrong there. You don't want to have the pipe where the batteries are for the top frame motors. You want it on the other side, because there you only have one motor that could connect, or one battery box rather, and this is this one. And another lag. Okay. What the hell? Okay. Now let's extend this a bit. And let's extend this a bit. And then what we want to do is, let me just put one there, and we want to put on. Okay, so you see how I'm doing it, and let me just stack it up. Pretty simple like that. Okay. And there I'm done. And then I'm stacking up the pipe. And then what I can do to make it a little bit easier on myself, what I'm just going to do, stack it up more. Okay, that should do. And again, just jump and right click, stack it up all the way. Now this is done. Now the other side. Nope, not this one. On this side, stack it up as well. And this is done as well. And now stack up the frame. And done. And now what I just can do to save myself the work of acting down there. Is it connected somewhere? Ah, well, yeah, well, it was connected to the button. then let me just, whoops, didn't want it that. That's not my intention. Where's the frame motor? There it is. Turn it in the right direction once again. Up and nope, wrong direction. Down and up, okay. Put this one there again. And now back to the thing I wanted to do. Where is the lever? There's the lever. Just move the whole thing down. Okay, that should do. Then just remove the access things. Okay. Now this is done. Now we can repair the cable I just broke. Okay. And put this one back. Okay. And we can also put one here. Okay, nice. And it's getting dark again. So now this platform is ready and we can now move the drill up and down. And of course we need to add the drill, just as we have there. And we are going to do that now. Put some there. And here I have and another leg. Wow. Okay, as you can see here, this one is a 3x3, and I'm going to do it here as well. 1, 2, and now I need some block breakers. Filter transposer, block breaker there. 1, 2, 3, and on the other side as well, 1, 2, 3. And the thing is, with this drill platform, you can't just move the drill down. You have to move it right, left, because you can't use a block breaker, because you can't. There is no other way to connect the block breaker to the frame, because the backside of it needs to be connected to the tube. And if you connect the tube to the backside, you need to do a frame on the sides to connect it, and then you have the problem that you cannot move it straight down, because you will always have a frame that's blocking the down direction, so you can't do that. What I'm going to do now is connect those. Let me just do a connection here. Why not? I could also connect it there, no problem. Okay. And now we need to think about what we connect. Well, no, that wouldn't work. Okay, now this one is set. We need to have that. Now this one wouldn't be connected. Okay. Now, of course, we want to collect from both sides, from this one and this one, so we need to have every one of those block breakers connected. And now it's pretty tricky to think about how you can connect all of those. So those are connected by those here. And the tubes on top of those are connected by this one with this, this with this, this with this. And now this one and this one needs to be connected. So we do this, this and this. And now those three are connected. And then of course we need to add another one on top to connect the complete thing. And to do it symmetrical, we wouldn't have to do that, but it looks a little bit better, so we just do this. And we have a cross on the side. And now those are connected. And what we do now is we can add those ones here. No, not there. Okay. And the thing is, why we should have those is if you think about if you are drilling down a 3x3, just like that, the side dirt right here would stick to the arm, and it would you wouldn't be able to move it down with the arm, and of course you don't want that because you would get stuck then. So you need to add this to all the sides that are exposed to the earth. And of course this one's here where the tubes are is just purification. And on the bottom as well. Okay, now we can't fill in this one because it isn't connected to any frame, because there's no frame, there's no frame, there's no frame, there's no frame. And well, let me think about it for a second. Well, there's a frame on the backside, so we would be able to close it up, I think. Okay. And for good measure, we close those up as well. Okay, now I think that should be it. And another leg. And let's just see if the frame is moving. So where's my lever again? So obviously it is moving, that's great. Okay, fix it again. So we are able to move the arm up and down. And now let me just recheck if those are working. Okay. The platform can still move with the complete arm. And this those were blue and yellow. Let me just fix those. This and this, I think. Yes. Pretty sure. Yes. Okay. Now, this is your basic setup for the drilling machine. And now comes the programming. Of course, well, one thing you might want to do, we need another cable and another color and some chests, of course. And let me just do that. Where are the tubes? Redstone tube there. Add those there. And those should be connected on the bottom. And of course those are not connected to any of this arm, so the arm can still move up and down and those will stay on the platform just how we want it. And now we will add some chests to the thing. Chests, okay. One chest here, one chest here, one chest here, and one chest here. Nice. And let's just retest this once more. Yes, as you can see, the arm moves up without moving anything here. Great. And again, fix this. Nice. And now what we want, or what we need, is we need to connect the cable, the bundled cable, with another color to this redstone tube, because we need to fire the block breakers down here. And of course we don't want to use another wire, that's why we have used the redstone tube. And now we need to connect the redstone tube to the bundled cable. And we can just do this, let's just say here. Let me just remove those just for now, so I can have a, so I can move around a little bit more freely. Ah, can't get this. Okay, now just clear out some of the inventory space. Okay, now we need a redstone. Yes, jacket with wire. Let's just take the wood one, if I can find it. Bookshelf, wood plank, yes. Now this is connected, and this should this should also be connected to this one here. And so we can put, where on which page is it? Yes, this page. And another color we haven't used, I think. Blue we haven't used. Well, let's just take green, I'm sure we haven't used green. And we don't even need any bundled cable here, okay? So, now this is connected, and now we can connect those. And now green is connected to the tube. And now we can fix those again. Right. And that's it. Now I wanna have gimme. Okay, now. Now from the electrical standpoint, this thing is done, and we close it up with another leg. Okay, nice. And it's getting dark again. Okay, what we wanna do now in the closing step is we wanna add the computers to control the platform. And let me just grab some. Where are they? Monitor, a CPU and the disk drive, an IO expander we need. And let me just think how I'm going to place it. Yes. I think that should work. I think that should work. Display on top, disk drive to the right. Yes, and the bundled cabled, the bundled cable right there. Let's just do this. Okay. And bundled cable connected up to the socket. And I think that should work, if I'm not mistaken. And just for looks, let me just add another one on the other side. And again, this is just purification to have it a little more symmetrical. One would suffice, of course. Now, do that to purify it a little bit. Another more planks, okay. Nice. Then we need the fourth boot disk to boot up one of the computers. Let me just do that. Yep, mine was initialized. And I don't think this is working now. Last time I tested it, it wasn't working. You cannot connect a back pane on a frame. Let's just see if this is fixed. Nope. As you can see, you place a back pane and it pops right off. So you can't connect more RAM. But to be honest, 600K or 600 bytes should be enough. I hope. Anyway. Yeah, now we can just test if... Oh, well. There's one thing I haven't just quite... Yeah, let's just... First, this one needs to be cleared on both sides. So the PC is connected. Okay. CPU, disk drive, and the monitor. Monitor and the disk drive. And of course, the monitor isn't connected, so I'm doing this to connect it. And now this should be fine. And of course, I can also purify it a little bit. Problem there. Of course, you need to think about it. You can only move 1,000 connected frames, so you don't want to purify too much because you, depending on how deep you want to dig with this thing, you need some more blocks up there. But again, this is just a sample. Okay, now where my boot disk is gone once again. Okay, pop this in and restart it. Okay, nice, it's working. And now we can check out the functionalities. Okay, grab my list here. So we had black and red. Red was down, black was up, I think. Let me just turn this way so we can see it on the side. And so if I do 1638. 1684, yes, this is the value for red, IOX exclamation. It moves up just as we wanted. 32768 IOX exclamation moves it down. 0 IOX exclamation. Okay, nice. So this is working. And now we need to check if the platform is able to move in any direction. And let us just check this one as well. And I had white and orange, so 1 IOX exclamation, yes. And if we just have a look, where is the white one? White, yes. So we have just moved the frame in this way. And now the motor is here, and we have the magenta one to reset the motor. And I'm just going to do that right now by using 2 IOX exclamation. 0 IOX exclamation. Okay, and now nope, okay. Yeah, right. Magenta is 4, yes. I think I have left out the orange cable, haven't I? Yes, I have, okay. I forgot the orange one. No big deal. 4 IOX exclamation, 0 IOX exclamation. So now, where is the white one? There is. Now, right. Now it worked. You can see now the motor is now on this part of the frame again and not anymore on this. So the platform is now fully functional and we can now beginning to program this thing.